Come on.
Problems?
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to see the other briefings, we can get started.
Show me what else you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the 11th Hour Gaming Channel. I am AJ Gels. Guys, we are back with Mafia 3. It's been a while since I played this game on camera. You know, I recorded about 6 parts on day one and have just been kind of dishing those out since then. But also since then, I've beaten this game on my own, and you guys are in for a ride. It is a very good story. Who do we want? We'll take the Irish first.
Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point for Dunn, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought it'd make things square with Sal, and he'd be able to get Point for Dunn back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah, just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point for Dunn. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.
All right.
Oh, watch yourself around my files. There's a...
Let's go find our good friend, Thomas Burke. Wait, was it Thomas? I can't remember. I think it's Burke. What the hell was his first name? Sorry, I'm slowly losing my mind. But yeah, overall, I mean, this game is it's really good. Overall, just the general experience. I don't know. I mean, I'll say I like this expression a lot. I think this is a game of this is a game of extremes. You know, gameplay wise, it's really pretty repetitive. The whole loop of taking down the rackets, it's not that interesting. I mean, it's oddly addictive, but it's just flat out uninteresting. Just seeing that, oh shit, don't explode. Mostly because it's just the same thing over and over and over again. But it is peppered up with a really good story. I like the characters. I think all the ideas were here. It's just they didn't tie them together perfect. I don't know. I think they took a shot at something and they just missed. I don't know. It's hard for me to put into exact words. But all in all, I mean, if you're on the fence of buying this game, I would say get it. You know, if you're a fan of these open world kind of games. I mean, not open world, I guess sandbox is the better term. I think the biggest comparison I hear is to Grand Theft Auto 3. I think that's the... that's the typical comparison I get. I keep hearing for this game. God, all the textural pop-up is really, really annoying. Yeah, and I'm sure listening to me keep saying it, it's also probably pretty annoying.
Burke. Been a while.
Lincoln Clay. Jesus Christ on the cross. Nasty and everything. I heard you were dead.
Been hearing that a lot.
The fuck do you want?
Came here to make you a business proposition.
Is that so?
I'm going after Marcano, his brothers, anyone else that's associated with him.
You know what may help?
The way I see it, once we deal with Barbieri, you get Point Verdun back. After that, we can discuss what happens to the rest of the city.
No, fuck off. All the chalky bastards once already. Look where that got me.
From where I'm standing, I'm not seeing much of a difference between then and now.
You listen to that, you listen to God, you fuck. Danny was so buttoned up, the coroner wouldn't let me get a last look. If anyone's killing that fucking Marcano, that's me.
Unless Marcano's hanging around one of these dive bars, I don't think he has too much to worry about.
Yeah, go fuck yourself. No more stones in the likes of you, there are fucking off. A fucking ingrate. Coming to your question, me. You and your kind, you cut and run at the first sign of trouble. You always have, you always will.
Time to drive like a madman.
Hands on the dashboard, motherfucker.
What the Christ you think you're doing?
You were bragging about your stones, so I figured we'd take a little ride. See who cracks first, the chalky or the Mick.
No, like, I really like this idea. I mean, I think it's kind of fun. It's weird. It's kind of dumb, arcadey.
Try the piss flaps of this, Molly.
Which I'll give it. I mean, I think it's pretty fun to mess around with. I don't know. I mean, like, well, first off, you never do it. You never interrogate these guys in, like, a really fast car. So it's kind of... I don't know. It kills a little bit of the fun that you have to do it in some of these cars that just don't accelerate.
You ain't proving nothing.
But turn that music off before I get in trouble with the copyrights.
You ain't proving nothing. Give me the word when you've had enough.
Relax the cocks already. I got drinking to do.
Pull over here. Now, get the fuck out of my ride.
Come around me, place in a bit. We got more to discuss.
Ah, Burke. First off.
Finally letting up.
Should probably start wiretapping Point Verdun.
Back so soon, then.
Tell me about Barbieri.
Barbieri? He's a right fucking cunt. I can tell you that much.
You know what I'm asking, Burke. Give me something I can use.
Barbieri's running Splow.
head of the Sweetwater Distillery.
Splow.
Panther's piss. White mule. Ollie gin. Portshane. Moonshine. You ignorant fuck. Christ, what kind of booze you people drink over there in Darkyville?
Kind that's not called painter's piss.
Boy, you ain't lived. Set the whole thing up myself. And that gunny fuck comes in and takes it from me. Smashes me knee all to hell. Barbieri's gonna suffer. You hear? Days. Slow.
What else has he got besides the distillery?
I runs that old Robert O. Slaughterhouse. He's doing more in there than cutting a lean ribeye. Drags in there. That's the end of you.
I'll do the heavy lifting on this, Burke.
Uh-huh.
Once Barbieri's dead, I'm counting on you to step up.
I'll do more than step up. I'll either be running this whole damn town or burning it to the ground. But honest, it'll make a whole lot of difference to me either way. A nation,
come on!
Once again. A nation once again. And Ireland long, a province be a nation once again.
You can't sing for shit. Vehicle delivery. Right. Well, we can't get any of these cars just yet.
Need some wheels. And Burke says you're the only person we're talking to about it.
Well, Burke's a fucking genius in that regard. I'll head on out to you now.
I'll deliver this car. Alright, looks like we only have one racket to take down right now, and that's the Moonshine racket.
Lincoln, over here.
Surprised to see you, Nikki.
I know what you're planning on doing, and I couldn't just sit here and watch my old man send you out half-cocked. Fuck.
Well, your dad's never been much for details.
Yeah, what he didn't tell you is that the man running the Sweetwater Distillery is named Carl Bevers. Hard-ass. Country asshole.
Appreciate it.
His family runs the shine through the business, sells it to local shops.
Bevers ever let on to where he keeps his stills?
He's got brains enough to move things around. Rumor is he's got a map hid somewhere for his drivers.
Something like that could come in handy. Maybe I'll convince one of his men to tell me where it is.
Hey, we've got another man, goes by the name of Bear, keeping an eye on the meatpacking plant. You should go see him.
I'll do that. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, Lincoln. I want to know what Bevers is up to. You're gonna have to get at some of his people.
All right. How are we gonna take this down? Enforcer that. That's a moonshine map. That's interrogation. Let's start over there. I'll probably be doing kind of a lot of cutting around, a lot of jump cuts, while I'm just kind of tearing down these rackets, because there's not a lot of story that's necessarily going on. It's more or less a bunch of interrogate and kill the enforcers and whatnot, so enjoy the weird montage or jump cuts or whatever, because I'm probably gonna turn my mic off for most of it, not do commentary through it. It's I don't know, I think it's just easier that way. It's more compressed, simpler to watch, instead of, I don't know, me doing this, just kind of ad-libbing to fill the space. Alright, so, like I said, enjoy, probably about 5 minutes of me shooting and blowing stuff up.
Gotta be around here somewhere.
You alright?
they got no fucking idea. Shot is fucking shot. I don't care what those cone asses in the bayou.
Huh? Fucking eyeballing him right now.
What's he thinking?
Getting behind something. Gonna put you down, son.
Fuck.
Fucking flies.
Other side. Spider one, boys.
How's it going, guys? I can't turn my mic. I don't know. I changed my mind.
Huh?
I do that a lot.
What the heck is that guy doing?
Trying to rob this place. Come in here. Where's the adrenaline?
Holy shit! Watch where you go.
Let's interrogate this guy. Like I said, I can't change my mind. I'm not gonna do this as a montage. I don't know. I might cut around here and there, just you know, cut out the transit. But I don't know. I'll make the decision on a case by case basis. Sorry, I know it's weird having me go through my process with you guys like that. It's I
go check this out.
It helps me to think out loud.
What?
Shit's closed.
Huh? Oh shit, that don't sound good.
No! This guy's coming for us!
Shoot that stupid bastard!
Got
us a gunfight.
Go.
Take him out. You Negroes are great for target practice.
Shit.
Shoot!
Hands on the dashboard, motherfucker.
Who the hell are you?
You're gonna tell me everything about Bevers' business.
Time for y'all to hear what the Hollers got to say. This is the Holler Speaks. And tonight we talking about this phrase I keep...
You really missed that, motherfucker! Look, Kate, folks, don't even tell me the fucking time, I swear!
Tell me what I need to know.
I'll tell you what I know. Nothing!
Sing, bitch!
If I knew anything, I'd tell you!
Your time's running out!
Oh, Jesus! My folks dropped me on my head. I don't remember shit!
Talk to me, asshole!
Drop me on the head.
Dad, crap!
All the cash we bring in from selling hooch, I know where it's being stashed.
Don't let me see you again.
There we go. There it is. Objective are we going to go to? Oh, we're going to rob a cop bar. Oh, that sounds like a smart plan.
Come at me, motherfucker!
That was the most southern way. Probably one of the most southern ways you could have said that. Come at me, motherfucker! I hope you enjoyed my terrible southern interpretation. No, I am not mocking people who talk like that. That is me mocking that specific line and delivery.
Got in deep to Barbieri. Last seen hidden in the road.
Did I just see something?
Truth. You'd think, but if he did, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Get the hell out of here. Alright. So we'll play into the cop bar. What else is there? Other than, yeah, we'll take out that enforcer and steal that map.
Sensitive assholes who never...
If you wonder why I'm running everywhere, just I don't know. I find it easier sometimes. Go find this enforcer. It's actually probably smarter if I... Yeah. I'm gonna go hit this junction box just so I can get the layout of his backup and whatnot.
Now I hate getting wet like this. Huh? You be cool. It
I could take hold of.
Call the cops!
Do not fucking
move. I like that face stamp. Take on the enforcer.
Do not fucking move.
Hey, thanks for coming with me. I hate walking out here on my own.
Right in the dome. I'm not in a stealth mood right now. Now I'm in the in a mood that's pretty much just shoot everyone. That I still have the some more work we can do. Just leaves money on the table.
Nobody. What?
What was that?
Should be around this corner. There it is.
Then make it happen. Over. Can't you see him on the phone?
What?
Rude motherfucker. So, anyway. I'll send my guys over to...
Alright. Steal the map to the moonshine camps.
Would you just move on?
Huh? It's nasty. watching him like rip out that guy's throat like that.
My whole life, right on the wall.
Up there in that building. Place is too big, I don't want to alert all the sentries. Get through that way. That door's not gonna open. There we go. Found the money to the moonshine stills.
You ain't dead, slug.
This is the way you die!
Well, looks like it's game time. I'm just gonna have a shootout with these guys while I do my sign-off. I'm gonna end this one here. Next video will, been not hunting me or something?
Run! He's gonna go!
Kill some fun. Okay, well, they're not gonna be searching for me. Either way, like I said, this is gonna be the end of this one. Thank you for watching, as always. Facebook, Twitter, and the website down in the description below. Next video, we'll finish up with this racket. You know, I'll destroy those, let's see here. Those moonshine stills, I think they're out in the bayou. Okay, we'll come down here, take out those moonshine stills, talk to Nikki, take out this racket boss, do the protection racket, and if we have time, we'll take out Burke's big enemy. But like I said, that's for next time, and until then, guys, like I said, social media, all in the description, and like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. But until then, guys, I'm AJ Gels. This is the Unfair Gaming Channel. Guys, thanks for watching. I'm out.